Good morning, good afternoon, and a good night to everybody. We are around the world. My name is Paolo Panerai. I am the founder and the owner of Domenica Stellare di Castellina. And thank you to everybody for the presence and the disponibility to participate at this global testing. Our first global testing have been in 2015 in cooperation with the British Telecom. This is the unique company with the possibility to connect all the world in the showroom. And for this, I think we created the format of the global testing. Now it's very simple with the platform Zoom and the other, but at the time it's necessary to have one great infrastructure to connect to all the world and to give the possibility to to listen and to appreciate it and to give the critic to the wine in different area of the world. This is one great value because the wine is always the same, but the other component in a different country can give the different result at the testing. This is the global testing in honor to celebrate the 40 vintage or harvest of our Isodi di San Nicolò. And it's a good occasion, this celebration, because just some month ago, Isodi di San Nicolò is celebrated like Italian wine, number one Italian wine. From the evaluation of the Italian critic, but also from the critics from the other country. This is one rating, global rating. And Isodi di San Nicolò for the second time, because also the vintage 2013 is in the same position, the second wine after Isodi di San Nicolò. Now is Solaia from Antinori, and the third is Sassicaia. So we are very, very, very happy for this result. And now will be other, will have in this occasion other very interesting wine. But I stop here my introduction. Just two other words for the introduce our great critic, the best of Italy, Daniele Cernilli. And Cernilli, together Alessandro Celai, many of you have a personal contact, a connaissance of Alessandro, is executive chairman of our company and our holding, DCC. And Alessandro, please introduce and start with the the testing. Thank you to everybody, and I hope this testing confirm the quality of high quality of our wine. Alessandro.
So, first of all, many thanks to all of you, dear partners, dear friends, dear supporters, to be with us today in this very important occasion to celebrate the 40 vintages of Isodi di San Nicolò. But before of everything, I really want to say special thanks to Daniele Cernilli, that, as Mr. Panerai said, is the most influential Italian critic. And as we are extremely happy and honored to have Daniele Cernilli with us. And secondly, I want to say special thanks to Mr. Panerai to give me the opportunity for more than 26 vintages to be the winemaker, the creator of this amazing wine and all the other wines of the DCC company. And so once again, thanks to all of you. All around the world, we have all the importers and globally, but also I want to say special thanks to all of our important Italian customers that are connected with us today. Grazie a tutti to be here. So starting as Mr. Panerai said, today we taste globally three of our Grand Cru wines, but again, the first and the reason of this important event is the celebration of Isodo di San Niccolò. But also the second and the third wine are very important wine in the portfolio of DCC company. That is Pinot Nero from Sicily, the Eterno, and the Rocca di Frassinello, that is the main label, the first label. But starting with Isodo di San Niccolò, Isodo di San Niccolò is since the beginning the flagship of Castellare, and since the beginning Sangiovese in Chianti region. And this is not a Chianti Classico, as all of you are, is very clear for all of you, because at the beginning, when the first vintage of Isodi was 1977. At that time, the appellation of Chianti Classico was included 10% of white grapes. So considering that this wine since the beginning is a single vineyard wine with 85% Sangiovese, Sangioveto clone, and 15% Malvasia Nera, so at that time wasn't inside of the appellation of Chianti Classico. So now, with the new regulation, Isodi di San Niccolò can be included in the Chianti Classico. But as many times we discussed with Mr. Panerai, Isodi now is very famous by itself. So everybody knows that Isodi di San Niccolò is one of the best wine, not in Italy, but in the world, globally. So for this reason, there is no reason to include Isodi di San Niccolò in the Chianti Classico appellation and to keep that in the IGT, the Super Tuscan line. As you can see, to celebrate the 40th anniversary, we decided to make a special dress for this wine. It's a fantastic black label. And for this reason, I also to say special thanks to our marketing team that they had a very strong work behind this label, and I think the label is very attractive, and also is the perfect label to celebrate this important event. The vintage is 2017. As everybody knows, 2017 was not a very easy vintage in all Italy, but especially in Tuscany. Was considered one of the hottest vintages in Chianti Classico. But once again, Castellina in Chianti, and especially Castellare, is located in an amazing amphitheater, open in, as you can see in this beautiful picture, open in one direction and closed in all of the others. So for this reason, even in a very hot seasons like 2017, we have always, especially during the summertime, a beautiful breeze coming up from the Valdelsa Valley. This is an important value because also in a very hot vintages, we can produce a very fresh wine with a good acidity and with a great potential to age the wine for a long time. You are tasting with us, and now I want to leave the conduction of the tasting to Daniele Cernilli to taste the wine with all of us. Grazie mille.
Thank you, Alessandro. Thank you, Paolo Panerai. It's an honor for me I have nothing to teach to anyone. Of course, I'm just a taster of Italian wines, not the best critic of Italy. It's not true. So, Isodi di San Nicolò 2017. I have an honor and the opportunity to taste all the vintages of Isodi di San Nicolò from 1977 to now. And so I know very well this wine, and I know the origin of this wine. It is in altitude area. We are between 400 and 450 meters on the sea level. The vineyards of Isodi di San Nicolò is a single vineyard, and it's very high in the landscape in the area of Castellina. We call High Castellina to call this part of Castellina, and this is a cold area. So also in a vintage like 2017, the weather was not so hot, was windy, and you know the wind chill is very important in the hot vintages, because refresh the area, and so the character of this wine are not so extreme. As in other part of Chianti Classico, as in other part of Italy, of course. So we are in altitude with Gallestro soil and Alberese soil mainly. So the classic soil of Chianti Classico, it's 85% Sangiovese. Sangioveto is the name, the real name of the clone, and 15% Malvasia Nera. From the beginning, the blend was in this way. So 30 months in French oak barrels, from 24 to 30, depends on the vintage, of course. And this is, in fact, a super task. But the reason was not because they hate the Chianti Classico, but because in 1977, it was illegal to put only Sangiovese and Malvasia Nera in the blend of the Chianti Classico. And at those time, if you wanted to make Chianti Classico, you had to use also the white varieties like Malvasia and Trebbiano Toscano in the blend. So when they started to make the Isodi di San Nicolò, was not possible to call it as a Chianti Classico. So he started as a Super Tuscan at the beginning. It was one of the first Super Tuscan produced in Chianti Classico. I don't remember many others in at those times. So the color of this wine is a classic color of the Sangiovese. It's a garnet ruby, not so concentrated, because the Sangiovese never gives a very concentrated wines. And it's very light ruby, light garnet ruby. The nose is another example of the classic taste of the classic nose of a great wine from Sangiovese and from Chianti Classico. So the cherries, of course, the berries, some spicy scents due to the character of the wines, due also to the barrel, the old French oak barrel aging, of course. So the Virginia tobacco a little bit, but the fruitness in this wine is very elegant, and the nose is complex and elegant at the same time. It is not so common. This is a real masterpiece for a 2017, and for the area of the Chianti Classico. If you taste, you know that the tannins eliminate the salivation, and the acidity helps the salivation, stimulate the salivation. And the balance between these two characters is very important to understand the character of the vintage and the character of the origin of the wine. Not only a Sangiovese, it's a wine that comes from a single vineyard with particular characters, gives to the freshness, to the drinkability, the best character of this wine. Probably this is one of the reasons for what this wine is so well evaluated by the international wine critics all over the world, because it's a real representative of the origin of this wine, of the area of this wine. So it's more important the origin than the variety, in my opinion, of course. The taste of this wine, as you easily can understand, the acidity wins on the tannins. And this is very, very important for so hot vintages, because normally in the hot vintages, the tannins are more evident than the acidity. In this case, the balance between the two elements, acidity and tannins, are very interesting. It's like a dialectic relationships between one and the other. And so you have the first part of the tasting in which the tannins are a little more evident. And then the acidity wins and stimulate the salivation, and there is a dilution of the tannins. So the balance is fantastic in this case. The hot vintage is not so evident in the character of this wine. Is an elegant wine, first of all, and not a wine that apparently comes from a so hot vintage. The length in on the palate is very long. The warmness in on the palate is very interesting, and the time in which you can remember the taste of this wine is a long time, because remain in the aftertaste for a real long time. Another consideration is the rule of the French oak barrels. It is not invasive, so it's very important to say that, because sometimes you drink wine with too much wood inside. We have two years and more in French oak barrels, but the character of the barrels, the spiciness of the that comes from the barrel is not in so evident, and this is a good thing in my opinion. It's easy to drink, and you can finish the glass of the wine before you want, probably, and this is another important character of this wine. So it's a dynamic balance. I call in this way, because there is a balance, a dialectic balance between the more important character, the more important elements in this wine. I don't want to talk about matching with food, of course, because we are experts, so you can easily understand what could be the matching. But I want to say another time that this is a wine in which the elegance is more important than the body, and it's in my opinion is a good compliment for a 2017.
Grazie mille Daniele. You mentioned some very important aspect that are always and for every vintage my column, no, in my winemaking style, especially considering that, as everybody knows, I had the opportunity to stay very close to Giacomo Takis, that is considered, for my personal opinion, the best winemaker in the world, but for sure the best in Italy since ever. And my opportunity, my fortune to stay close to him, he teach me many, many beautiful things. But the main things that I appreciate very much from Giacomo Takis was that he always said to me, please, in every good wine, you must recognize three fundamental elements. The first, you must recognize the territory. So in every wine, when you taste, you have to say this is made in Castellina or in other region. The second, you must recognize the grape. And the third one, you must recognize the idea, the style of the winemaker. And the elegance is the harmony of everything. So you mentioned elegance. And so for me, elegance is the main aspect when I make every wine I make. I always try to research the elegance first of all.
As you remember, Alessandro, Giacomo Takis talked about the souplesse. So the balance between the elements of the wine and the drinkability of the of every wine. So this was the idea, the main idea of the winemaking for Giacomo Takis.
Yeah, for sure. In fact, you are remembering to me one very beautiful anecdote talking with Giacomo. He always say, if you want to be sure to make a good wine, as soon as you make the first blend, bring the bottle to your house. If between you and your wife or girlfriend or whatever, you have to finish the bottle. So if you finish the bottle, you are in a good way. That was the dimension of Giacomo or Giacomo Takis. Now, this is Alessandro, a very important thing, drinkability. Yes.
Alessandro, thank you to Daniele Cernilli. The name
Italy, was an honor for me. Eh?
Of Daniele is Dr. Wine. And more I like remember who is Giacomo Takis. Giacomo Takis is the father of Tignanello, Sassicaia, Solaia, and so. And is in effect the teacher, and Alessandro is the delphin of Giacomo Takis. I like said something more about the anniversary with the special edition. Firstly, the label you have the opportunity to see directly. Secondly, we have the big format, one limited edition of a big format, 15 and 18 liter. Part of this is destinate of the autumn auction in Christie's, from Christie's. Secondly, we publish one book, artistic book, a limited edition, about the bird in our label from the last 40 years. And this bird come from one historical book on ornithology from one extraordinary person, English person, John Gould. John Gould gave the input to Darwin to study the evolution of the space. And so this book will be printed in only 100 copy, and will be the same in the auction. So the event, especially in the moment when you receive the award, like first Italian wine, is a very extraordinary combination also for our importer and our partner in any country. I like you remember this, in autumn will be the auction, and we are sure the value also in the market go up, because this wine is very extraordinary, not only because it received the award, the first Italian wine from Parker, James Suckling, Antonio Galloni. So thank you very much, and you can follow, I think, with the second wine.
Before to pass to the second wine, I want to say just a few information, enologically speaking, about Isodi di San Niccolò. Normally, Isodi di San Niccolò vineyard is the latest in terms of harvest, considering that normally the average harvest in our area is between the third and the fourth week of September. Isode di San Nicolò is always not before the second week of October. So this is extremely important. And also in a hot vintage like 2017, our harvest for Isode di San Nicolò vineyard was in the 10th of October. This is a very important element to understand how long is the vegetation, and the vegetation period is extremely long, starting from the flowering and ending to the harvest. And the second thing is the selection of the grapes. So we do an extremely high selection in the vineyard. So all of our team is carefully selected in order to pick only the perfect bunches in the vineyard. And secondly, we do another important selection in the cellar before to start the fermentation. So we select individually cluster by cluster. And also we do the berry selection. So three different selection in order to select only the perfect berries to start the fermentation. Fermentation is made in stainless steel with the full control of temperature. Temperature of fermentation is between 24 and 26 Celsius degrees. Normally fermentation and maceration it's about 3 weeks, 3 or 4 weeks, so depend of the vintage. And then we do the malolactic fermentation in concrete. After that, we move to the French oak, and we keep there between 24 and 30 months, depend of the vintage. Isode di San Nicolò 2017 was in French oak for 24 months, 50% is new and 50% second time. And then we bottled, and we keep in bottle for another minimum between six to 12 months before to send to the market. Again, grazie mille to Daniele to present the tasting of this wine. So we go to the second, that is L'Eterno. L'Eterno is made in Sicily, in our important property called Feudi del Pisciotto. Feudi del Pisciotto is located between Piazza Armerina and Caltagirone in the southeast of Sicily. And this property, it's very important to understand exactly the property, is that is one of the few property in Sicily. And this picture is very propedeutic to understand what I'm saying. It's one of the few property in Sicily making Pinot Noir. Because, as you know, Sicily has a very hot microclimate, but in our property we have a very big fortune, very big lucky to have two beautiful hills between 250 and 280 meters elevation. That is not a small elevation considering for that side of Sicily. And in the second hill, we found one of the most beautiful piece of soil for Pinot Nero. And this wine was suggested directly from Giacomo Tacchi. So I am extremely passionate, connected with this wine, because this wine come from one specific suggestion of Giacomo Tacchi, that he knows perfectly every square centimeter of Sicily. And he recommended one day when we was there with Mr. Panerai to plant Pinot Noir, because that is the right place to plant a Pinot Noir. In fact, it's a small production, only that small piece of soil was perfectly indicated to produce Pinot Noir. And we are presenting today the 2016 vintage. 2016 vintage is considered, for my personal opinion, but not only for me, Daniele can confirm that 2016 in Sicily was one of the best vintage in the last 20 or 25 vintages, because was warm, but not too warm. And then we, in fact, was one of the few vintages where the irrigation system was in use just for a few days, only because we had a beautiful refresh, a beautiful breeze coming from the sea. We are just in front of the Gela Sea, and especially the vineyard of Pino Nero is on top of this beautiful hill, and from there coming this beautiful breeze and refreshing and cooling down the temperature between night and day. This is extremely important to get the character inside of the wine. The property has 55 hectares of vineyard fully planted, and the main grape planted is Nero d'Avola, and then we have Frappato, and then we have and then we produce also Cerasuolo di Vittoria, that is the only one of the OCG of Sicily. And basically in Feudi del Pisciotto we are using the same philosophy that we are using in Castellare, so no blend between indigenous and international grapes. The very high evaluation of indigenous grape, we are producing 100% Nero d'Avola in the top level called Versace Nero d'Avola, and then also in the entry level line called the Baglio del Sole. And then we have Grillo, we have Insolia, we have Cataratto, so all produced 100% of them. And then also we have some international grapes like Cabernet, like Merlot, like Syrah, but again produced 100% of each, just in order to protect the indigenous grapes and to make the evaluation of them in each glass that we are presenting all over the world. I want to leave the word to Daniele Cernilli to taste with all of us l'Eterno Pinot Nero 2016, that once again is, for my personal opinion, the best since the beginning for this beautiful wine. And then after I want to inform you about some enological information. Grazie Daniele.
Yes, thank you. It's very uncommon to have Pinot Noir in Sicily, in so Mediterranean area. We are in the south, of course, but I call Sicily as a pocket continent. Why? Because in Sicily there is the Etna, for example, that is 3,000 meters on the sea level, a great volcano, and then we have the island of Pantelleria that is in the middle of a Mediterranean weather. So very different, in few kilometers change everything, it's incredible the differences that you can find in Sicily as weather, soils, conditions, and viticulture, of course, from the east to west change really the world. It's not so strange to have a Pinot Noir in the situation in which Feudi del Picciotto is, because we are in Miscemi, that is a little town in the southeast of Sicily, but at the feet of the Iblei Mountains, for example. So in the relatively cold area for Sicily, of course. So the Pinot Noir can explains itself as a good Pinot Noir, nothing in common with Burgundy, nothing in common with Oregon, of course, very different. Not in the color is the color of the Pinot Noir, that is a light garnet, classic color of the Pinot Noir. The nose, it's a little different from what you can expect if you pay attention only to varietal scents. Because of course, the wild strawberries, probably red currant in the nose, but also some balsamic scents, like eucalyptus, mint, something like that. No? And this is the character of a Mediterranean Pinot Noir. Different from the I don't know, the cold scents in some part of Burgundy. Fantastic wines, but very different. Different also for the acidity. It's present as the acidity in this wine, of course, and you can have a salivation in your mouth. So the acidity, there is acidity, but there is also a roundness on the palate that is not so common for a Pinot Noir. There is a warm character on the palate, more roundness than edges on the palate. And this is a Mediterranean character. And this was the character that's liked to Giacomo Tacchis, for example, that wanted wine with roundness, with souple. And this is a wine with souple, with the character of Pinot Noir and the character of a Mediterranean wines. This wine aged for something more than 1 year in French oak barrels, if I remember right. And there is a warm finish on the palate. It is very, very pleasant in my opinion. So Pinot Noir, but not only Pinot Noir. There is half Pinot Noir and half Mediterranean areas, Mediterranean characters. And this is important because, in my opinion, the origin is more important than the variety. And in this case, you can recognize the origin of this wine more than the same of the variety. So it's a good cross between origin and the Pinot Noir varietal characters. And this is the best compliments I can do to this wine that is in fantastic vintage, because 2016 is a very good vintage for Sicily and for a great part of Italy too, of course.
Grazie Daniele. Sì, you are completely right. This is a great Sicilian Pinot Noir, in the sense that the Sicilian character is perfectly recognizable. The warm character is there, but is not covering, you know, the sense, the elegance of the grape.
It's not too edgy.
Exactly.
Too vertical.
Correct. Correct. And I want also to confirm to you that the sensation you had, so regarding the balsamic note. The balsamic note is a signature of Feudi del Pisciotto. You know very well all the line of Feudi del Pisciotto since our beginning, because you was the first taster of all of our wines, starting from the first vintage. And you can confirm that this line of taste, this balsamic note, especially eucalyptus, is the signature in all of the line of Feudi del Pisciotto. Means that this is the characteristic of our soil that is exactly signing the wine. Regarding the winemaking process, the wine is fermented in stainless steel and aged, as you perfectly said, only 1 year in second time French oak, no new oak for this wine. That is extremely important because the notes of Pinot Noir are very delicate, and we don't want to cover that very, very beautiful notes of silky and very elegant notes of Pinot Nero. And after that, just a very, very light paper filtration, and the wine is bottled, and we keep in bottle for another year and a half before to send to the market.
Two words only about this wine. The name L'Eterno. L'Eterno is the hand of a god, because there is one sculpture in Sicily, and we support restoration of this. And then is L'Eterno is the means to God, is in other words. And secondly, you know, Alessandro is a very specialist of the Pinot Noir, because I have one vineyard in Castellina, and they produce probably one of the best or the best Pinot Noir in Italy.
Grazie, Dottor Panerai. Grazie mille. And so, going to Rocca di Frassinello. Rocca di Frassinello deserves just two words of the presentation of the project, because this is one of the most important wine project in Italy, but not only. The project was born in 1999 with the first Italian and French joint venture between Castellare and Chateau Lafite Rothschild. through the great friendship between Mr. Panerai and Eric de Rothschilde. And the location is the center of Maremma, and we are in Giuncarico. We are very close to the sea, so only 10 kilometers in our direction, but we have a very good altitude. So we are between 200 and 300 meters elevation. It's one of the few perfect soil to produce Sangiovese in the entire Maremma. And at the same time, is a fantastic soil for international grape. And another very important aspect of Rocca di Frassinello is the cellar. As the picture shows, Rocca di Frassinello has the honor and the privilege to have the only one cellar designed by Renzo Piano, considered one of the best architects in the world. And the barrel room is the heart of the cellar. The concept of Rocca di Frassinello cellar is made totally by gravity, three different levels. So the first to do the selection of the grapes, the second of the fermentation area, and the lowest is the barrel room, one of the largest barrel room in the world, with over 3,000 barrel capacity. And so today we are presenting the new vintage of the flagship wine, that is Rocca di Frassinello, following the Bordeaux classification. The first label has the full name of the project. For your information, but all of you are everybody knows about the production of Rocca di Frassinello. Rocca di Frassinello produces between 350 and 400,000 bottles in 5 different red wines and 1 white. The white is the Vermentino, and the reds are starting from the entry level Poggio alla Guardia, and then we have Ornello and Le Sughere at the middle range. And then we have Rocca di Frassinello at the top, and then we have the diamond of the project, that is Baffo Nero. Rocca di Frassinello is made with 60% Sangioveto, the same clone of Castellare, and 20% is Cabernet Sauvignon, and 20% are made by Merlot. And this is following our joint venture, that is the best combination between the very high experience in Sangiovese from Castellare and the very high experience of Cabernet and Merlot from Chateau Lafite. In fact, the clones of Cabernet and Merlot are selected by Chateau Lafite. The vintage is 2017, that has the same climate characteristics of that we had in Chianti, very warm character, but again, we have a very beautiful connection with the sea, bringing the breeze every single night and reducing the temperature and helping to make a big variation of temperature between night and day. So, Daniele, I leave you the words for the tasting.
You can say under the Tuscan sun in this case.
Correct.
Because this wine is a concentration of Mediterranean characters. The characters of the Sangiovese is more mature than in Sodi di San Nicolò, of course. And the touch of Cabernet and Merlot gives some sense of blackberries, I don't know, blackcurrant, like that. So in the color is deeper and more concentrated, in part due to the presence of Cabernet and Merlot. But if you have only Sangiovese in Maremma, the color is deeper than in Chianti Classico, because the light is different, and you know, the producing of anthocyanins is due to the force of the light, and so in this case all the Sangiovese too could have a different color from the insider part of Tuscany. The nose is spicy, Virginia tobacco, some black cherries, blackberries, like that. And in the mouth, the body is very important. The warm character of this wine is evident. The tannins are more evident than the acidity, the opposite of Isode di San Nicolò, because the origin is very different. So they describes two different origins, and this is very important because, as I told before, in my opinion, the origins is very important, more than the variety. So when you say Sangiovese, you say few, because the most important thing is from where the Sangiovese comes from. So, and this comes from the Tuscan sun, and the Sodi comes from a colder area, and they are coherent with this kind of origin. And this is very important. If you taste a wine from Napa Valley, it's different from a wine from Bordeaux, of course, no? Because it's Cabernet too, Chateau Lafite and the Screaming Eagle probably has the same blend, but the origin are so different. And so in this case, it's things like that. One is the colder area inside the Chianti Classico, and the second is close to the sea, in the middle of a sunny area. So the difference is very evident, and this is the most important thing. This is a wine that, I don't know, embrace your palate, and the warm character is the main thing to say in this wine. The tannins are not aggressive. There is tannin in this wine, but not so aggressive. So the salivation, you can have some salivation, less than drinking Isodi probably, but there is. So the tannins are not so aggressive, not so drying. And this is very important because the velvet tannins, as Takis said many years ago, is the best character of a big red wine from this case, from Sangiovese, Merlot and Cabernet. Unfortunately, I have to leave you. I want to thank you for the attention and for the honor that I had to comment these wines. Isode di San Nicolò is one of the best wine of the world, really. And for the Sangiovese, I don't remember better wines in the Chianti Classico area. And is out of any doubt one of the best expressions of the territory of Casellina in Chianti, and one of the best expression of Sangioveto of ever, in my opinion. So happy birthday to Isode di San Nicolò, happy first 40 years, and we hope for the next 40 years, of course. In 40 years, we can meet again to celebrate the 80 years of Isode di San Nicolò, I hope, of course. Thank you very much. Thank you,
grazie mille, Daniele.
Thank you, Alessandro.
Grazie mille, Daniele.
Enjoy these fantastic wines.
Grazie, Daniele. Grazie di tutto. Grazie davvero.
Thank you.
Ciao.
I like to show the type of the page of the book with all the bird of the last 40 years of our wine in Castellare di Castellina. Now all the people talk about the sustainability. We start with the sustainability 40 years ago, and the bird are the symbol, because in our vineyard don't use chemical product of synthesis, but only natural product. It's not the production very easy, but we start 40 years ago. In the book, the special book, we have all this image historical because the design is exceptional from John Good. The second thing before to start with the word, I like introduce Gianluca Picca, probably many of you know yet, is have the responsibility of the coordination of the export. Gianluca, thank you to be here together. Okay, Alessandro, you can follow.
Thank you, everyone.
This is, also from my side, I want to say thanks to Gianluca to join us. And I am sure that Gianluca has the power and all the characteristics to bring higher and higher the level of Castellare distribution around the world. And just to finish the Rocca di Frassinello, a few words about the winemaking process. The grapes are fermented separately, of course, because Sangiovese is and Cabernet Merlot are the harvest is made in a different period. But there's the fermentation in stainless steel and malolactic fermentation in concrete, and then the wine is aged for 2.5 years in French oak. 60% is new oak and 40% is second time after Chateau Lafite wine. So following our relation with Chateau Lafite, we have the right to use the second time barrels of Chateau Lafite. After that, so we bottled without any filtration or fining, and in order to preserve the integrity of the grapes. And after that, we bottled and we keep in bottle for minimum 1 year, 1 year and a half before to produce. So the wine, as Daniele said, is a beautiful combination between power and elegance at the same time. But once again, is the microclimate territory is perfectly recognizable in this wine. Once again, thanks to all of you to be with us today. I am with Mr. Panerai, totally available for you now for your question, and we will be more than happy to answer to all of them.
Buongiorno.
Ciao Michele, how are you?
Ciao Alessandro.
Good to see you, first of all. Happy to see you, first of all.
It's very happy to see you, very healthy, and it's great to see you. And yeah. The wines were absolutely beautiful. Grazie. I have a question about the L'Eterno, but that's more of a question about Sicily and the Pinot Noir. Because of Sicily's climate, is it difficult to have vintage variations?
Of course, we had, in our experience, very important vintage variations. Not every vintage is really different to the others, but for example, 2016 was completely different to 2017. And 2018 was very close to 2016. And 2019 and 2020 was also very close to 2016. But 2017 was, like in many other parts of Italy, was really, really, really different. Again, 2010 also was another vintage completely different to the average. So because we are not, as you know, we are not at the sea level, no? So we are close to the sea, but we have 250 average elevation above the sea level. So we have a beautiful influence. And again, we have a fantastic exposure, especially in the second hills of the property, in the Piano Spineto, where the Pinot Nero is planted. And in that specific area, we have a sort of a special connection from the sea to the hill. And we got every single night a beautiful breeze starting from end of April till the last day before the harvest. A beautiful breeze reducing the temperature and making a good excursion between the night and day. So just to give you an example, during the day we can go between 35 or 37 degrees, and during the night we go between 16 and 17. So it's a huge difference between night and day. This is extremely important, first of all, to get the character of Pinot Nero into the juice, and secondly, to make the vegetation period a little bit longer. And as usual, as much we can, we try to have the vegetation period longer, because it's extremely important to have a better ripeness and then a better expression into the glass.
The harvest is consistently around the same time each year, though, correct?
Correct. And Pinot Nero, normally we do the harvest between the second and the third week of August.
Thank you.
Sometimes a little bit earlier. For example, the 17, we did the 27th of July. So it was a incredible, no, but just to give you now the differences in some vintages comparing to the others. But norm constantly is between the first and the second week of August.
Thank you.
Grazie mille, Michele. Thank you to be with us.
I am imported in Belgium. Vines.
Ciao, how are you?
Piacere, grazie.
Happy to see you.
I'm very good, thanks. I had my first vaccination, and I hope by summer we will all be vaccinated and I can come and visit you in Tuscany. I don't know if you can, because the problem we had during the quarantine, the lockdown, we didn't have much opportunity to taste new vintages at ProWine or at Vinitaly. So I was very curious to know how the vintages are going to become in the future. I mean, I just received a Chianti Classico Riserva 2018. I haven't tasted them before I ordered them because I didn't have the chance to taste the wines. But I mean, I can compare, like, for example, the older vintages, like I liked very much 13, I liked very much 15, was also a warm year, but it was a very nice year, I think, for Sangiovese. 16 is my favorite vintage because it's got the freshness and the acidity. 17, I like very much at Castellare because they really kept the freshness, I think. And can you say something about the vintages actually on sale now, 18 and 19? Let's say for a Chianti Classico 18 compared to 19. And maybe you can already give some prospects how the vintage 2020 was in Tuscany for Castellare.
Okay. So starting first about 2018. 2018 was a very fresh vintage. For my personal opinion, was one of the great vintages for Castellare, because it was much easier than in other vintages to keep the acidity and to keep the freshness due to the microclimate condition. Mm-hmm. And so in terms of potential of aging, eligibility, as you ask me, I can consider 2018 not probably one of the longest, but for sure it's a medium long eligibility time. So it's about for Chianti Classico between 10 to 15 years for sure, no problem. And the Riserva a little bit longer. So about 20 years without any problem. But the beauty of this vintage is the freshness and the beautiful acidity that you can breathe starting from the nose. This is an amazing character of 2018. 2019, what I can say, so for me, was the greatest like 2016 and 2019 was very similar vintages in terms of vegetation period, very long, one of the latest in terms of harvest. We did the harvest of Forisodi di San Nicolò, just to give you an example, in the third week of October, one of the latest in terms of harvest. And also for the Chianti Classico, the harvest of 2019 was very late comparing with the average, the third and the fourth week of September. And but the example of the beauty of 2019 is made by the market with and I want to say thanks to all of you partners from Italy and from all over the world, because 2019 is going even in the pandemic situation. Thanks to all of you. 2019 is flying. The Chianti Classico 2019 is flying, and all the customers that approaching 2019 carefully due to the pandemic, due to the all the situations, as soon as they taste, everybody reorder, because 2019 has a fantastic balance between the power and the freshness and the elegance. One of the best vintages since my beginning in Castellare. And 2020 is it's another fantastic vintage, more close, just to give you an example, 2013. 2020 was really, really close to 2013. So one of the, in terms of the scale of quality, starting from 0 to 10, it probably is not 10, but is 8.9 or 9. So it's very, very high level of quality. Is a perfect balance again, like 2019, that is remain for my personal opinion the highest, but is also very close in 2020. Good balance between power and freshness. More probably a little bit more, the balance is a little bit more in the direction of body versus the elegance, but just a little bit. So if we have to analyze 2019 and 2020, of course 2019 it's a little bit higher, but also 2020 it's still very, very high.
Okay, thank you.
And thank you to all of you again. Mattia Tobacco is one of our fantastic partners that we have, and I want to say, please, Mattia.
From our side, we don't have specific question, but
ecco. Ciao Mattia.
Ciao Alessandro, an honor to speak with you. We are here with all of the wine team of Oena. We are missing a couple of people because they are enjoying the Amaro holidays, but you don't see on the camera just enough the director of the wine team, Master of Wine, Olivier Gasselin, the Olivier Trade, our assistant buyers, our intern Francesca, and the director of Oena House. Thank you very much for the outstanding job that you did with this vintage. To be honest, sometime you know, in particular with the 17 is not nice, but there are some vintages that we would like to forget, but in your case, the job, the outstanding precision that you had for this wine permit us to enjoy beautiful bottles. Congratulations, really. We can image of can be hard to challenge with warm vintages, and thank you, Alessandro, to give the chance to us to drink your wonderful wine, really.
Grazie Mattia. Thanks to from all of us to Eno Future to help us to bring all of our wines in top of UK. Grazie mille.
Thank you.
Grazie. Thank you to all of you, as you are a fantastic, fantastic team. Thanks to all of you. Mr. Cosa should be Paolo Porfidio, and then another master of wine, dear friend and a great partner from Greece, Costantino Lazarakis. So first Paolo Porfirio and then Costantinos.
Good morning Alessandro, good morning to everybody. How are you?
We are fine, thank you to be with us.
Thank you for this invitation, and I would like to first say congratulations to everybody, the team, and in first of you, because for me, you know, you are one of the best wine maker in the world, and every wine, every year are the confirmation for this, because after 40 years, the Sodi di San Nicolò remain one of the best kind of wine on the Chianti Classico, and always every year with the vintage particularity, but every year remain one of the best. So Pinot Noir as well. Sorry, I was late because I worked, but right now I'm serving the wine.
Grazie, grazie mille.
And so,
grazie mille Paolo.
Congratulations, grazie a voi veramente.
Thank you, thank you to support all our labels, and always to bring our labels into the table of the great persons. Thank you very much, Paolo.
Grazie a voi. Thank you very much. Continuate così.
Grazie Paolo, grazie mille. And now to Mr. Costantinos Lazarakis. Again, it's Master of Wine, the first and the only one Master of Wine in Greece, dear partner and dear friend. Ciao Costantinos.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, of course. Happy, okay. Happy to see you in person.
It's great.
Happy to see you.
I hope we'll meet before too long, my dear.
Yes.
Just to start by saying thank you. I mean, this is an amazing tasting, and we really love the wines. We opened the bottles 11 o'clock this morning, and we invited all the people from Eolos to slowly come in groups of two or three to taste, because we don't want to have our offices full of people still. We have to be very careful. And I have been tasting these wines since that time, and I can say that every single glass sings and keeps on adding more layers as you get more oxygen into this. I'm really delighted. What I would like to ask is the aging ability of these three wines. How much? I mean, all of them are babies. They do have a long future. But capitalizing on your experience, what would be, you think, the optimum time to drink each of these three wines? Thank you.
Thank you, Costantinos. The starting from Pinot Nero. Pinot Nero is perfectly drinkable right now, and also has a quite long ageability. So it's about 10 to 15 years. And then Rocca di Frassinello as well is start to be drinkable right now. Preferably, I recommend to wait a little bit longer. So the end of this year will be the best time to start to drink the Rocca di Frassinello 2017. And Isodi, it needs a little bit longer. So it's of course it's already drinkable, because our policy is without drinkability we are not in the idea. So in a good idea to send the wine to the market. So of course the minimum drinkability is there, but if you ask me when this wine start to be real in a great shape is beginning next year. And in terms of ageability, longevity, this wine has no less than 30, 35 years of life, for sure. Even in a hot vintage, for all the situation for all the reasons we said at the beginning, because in this wine we had the fortune due to the geographic area where the vineyard is located, to save and to keep a beautiful acidity, and with the tannins has a perfect balance, so to bring a freshness and body and beautiful silky taste into the tannins. That is, for my personal opinion, it's a quite long ageability, so minimum 30 years. Grazie mille, Costantinos. Thanks to be with us. Very appreciated.
Yeah. Thank you for this opportunity. This is one of the best virtual testing I ever attend. Congratulations. But honestly, I know very well your wine, so it's for me, it's not new. I was also in your cellar a couple of years ago, so I know really the quality of your wine, and I'm happy some of my customer here, partner, they attend also, and congratulations. Very good.
No, but you said that you know well our wine. But now we have Isodi di San Nicolò receive for the second time the award, the best Italian wine, not only from Tuscany and from Chianti area, is from Italy.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, okay. I know. And soon we will have here in the Philippines. We need just to wait.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your presence.
Mr. Petitejani is our Japanese yes. importer.
Mr. Celai, hello, how are you?
Hi, Mr. Petitejani, how are you?
Yeah,
happy
thank
to
you
have
very
you
well.
Here connected with us.
Actually, what I wanted to say is, you know, I haven't been able to travel for 1.5 years now because of this whole situation.
As everybody, yeah.
And I must say, it is really extraordinary. And I want to thank you very much for letting us, you know, give us this opportunity to taste these wines here. I enjoyed
them
extremely well. In particular, I love the Isodici and also the Rocca di Frosinella is really great. I will recommend to my team to try to do more and on that end.
Thank you very much.
So the only question I really had, because there are not many questions about the wines left, you know, because mostly we know, but you had an experience which I didn't have. You caught Corona. I wanted to know whether, because people say it affects the taste, you know, the ability to taste. Did you have any of that experience or not at all?
No, fortunately, I had many other effects, but
okay.
Fortunately, nose and taste was good since the beginning. I never disappear, and even just the day after my hospital, when I come back to the house, I started to taste the wine just in order not to drink. I couldn't, but just to taste, to make a good exercise to my nose and to my palate, and just to understand if I had some difficulties, but always still in a good shape.
Right.
But it's the hand of the God in the label of l'Eterno.
Oh, yes. I think, yes, that was helping him a lot, I guess.
No, I was very high protected from God and from Mother of God to keep myself safe.
Thank you.
Grazie mille.
Thank you very
Mr.
much.
Thank you,
Mr. Panay. Thank you, Mr. Celai. And all the best. Thank you.
And Mr. Rafailov, fantastic pleasure to have you connected in face with us.
Yes, thank you. First of all, thank you for this great
ciao, opportunity. Leonid.
Ciao, ciao. We had, fortunately, we had already on our stock Isodi 2017. I drink half of the bottle and absolutely happy because it's fantastic wine. Thank you for this great
just on time, because unfortunately was impossible to send you the samples through the normal way, but fortunately exactly. you got the wines from your order. Thank you very much.
Yes, definitely.
Mr. Leon, what value do you think have Isodi di San Nicolò in terms of the price? Because we have the competitor under us for the quality and have a higher price. And so I like said for the value of the wine, I like give the opportunity to have a more profit with our improve of the price, so we can offer the more competition. One information, all the Isodi is finished, and all the crew will be with allocation. And so I have the pleasure to require to the our partner the target is to obtain the good price in the market and to eliminate any type of the parallelism, because with the e-commerce is very simple, and we go in the level of the top of the wine. And one key point is to maintain the correct price for all sell. And then we are sure you are ready for our cooperation.
Mr. Panerai, just to say that you will be very happy that in the Bolshoi Theater, and Leonid can confirm, there is a fantastic restaurant comparing with the three Michelin star restaurant around the world. And in that restaurant, Baffo Nero is the highest price for all Italian wines. For all Italian wines, Baffo Nero has the highest price. Confirm, Leonid?
Yes, it's our valuation.
Yes.
Mr. Panerai, it's absolutely expectable that you finish all the stock of this 2017 vintage, because it's very high quality. And I agree with you that we have to evaluate it higher. And for us is obvious, and we do it because the value of these wines, of we taste it, it's really higher, and the quality is higher than it's priced now. But we have to be very careful with price increasing and with positioning, because it's more marketing issue. It's not only commercial one. Our right positioning, working on the brand equity, and we have to be to take care when we do some movings higher. Or just my short comments, if it's understandable.
Okay, but
grazie, Leonid.
We are sure you can cooperate like other importer, our partner, in this target, because the market is changing in the moment when the wine can go everywhere in the world with the e-commerce, and then it's very important to have the same price around the world. Because in different cases, there is the specialist of the parallelism, and this is very dangerous for the market and for the importer, official importer.
Mr. Panerai, because we are not Europe, for us it's parallelism absolutely impossible. But having around 20 years of history of cooperation with you, with your company, with Mr. Alessandro Celai, you can rely on us, and we will be in cooperation for sure.
Okay. Thank you, because I see behind you the diploma of Baffonero.
Yes.
Do you know we he produce a special limited edition in the honor of Luna Rossa? Do you know Luna Rossa is the competitor of the in the America's Cup? And then we produce one limited edition with the name Baffo Rosso.
Wow.
Okay. And this is another occasion for the evaluate the correct our wine. We have many activity in terms of the marketing, but not with fantasy marketing, with the marketing about the quality and the value of the wine. You saw that San Nicolò have been 2 times in the undertop of a Wine Spectator in 1988 and 1989. And the more now have received this award from the four more important critic, international critic, and also the Italian critics. And it's clear the Italian know well, better probably, the market and the quality of the all Italian wine. If together they give this award, I think this is one point to evaluate and to promote. And so in this direction, I will send the material for this. Okay?
Perfect, perfect.
Thank you.
I'm proud and I'm happy to have this diploma, and it's only diploma I have behind of me. It's big honor to me. And I have this in my office.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Eccolo, Giuseppe Federico. Ciao.
Very quickly, just to say hi and thank you. We're very grateful to be here today with you. Thank you, Mr. Panerai. Thank you, Alessandro. And a special welcome to Gianluca, to the team. We look forward to meeting you all. Was just that, to show some gratitude. We hope
thank
to...
you. Grazie. Thank you, but I like said something because Vias, I explained for the all, is the importer of our estate, Rocca di Frassinello and Feudo del Pisciotto.
For
and
US.
Then, in the past, Vias is the specialist of the Sicilian wine. And now we test the value of the Pinot Noir. Is incredible wine, and so I hope you work just to recuperate the market for the not only for Le Sughere di Frassinello, but Rocca di Frassinello and the other Sicilian wine, because we have a great space in the United States, and you have the great capability for this, because you have a long experience with the Sicilian wine. You imported for a long time Planeta with the great successful, and I am sure you can give the more space of our Sicilian wine in US. Thank you.
Mr. Panerai, we look forward to working with you and growing the Feudi at the best of our capabilities. Thank you very much. It's a great honor again, and we really value your partnership.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for nice conversation, for nice introduction and tasting. We are from Latvia, because I didn't know how to write it down in this, and I'm ashamed that I allocated only 12 bottles of San Nicolò. this is my fault. I'm
pay attention, because they are not a big quantity of Isoldi
now. I know.
If you like, obtain the consensus from your client, we must offer the bottle.
Yes, of course. If you can
the bottle,
increase, because I let to know our clients how good it is right now during this conversation, your introduction, and I'm a huge number of clients asking, I want one, want any. Could you please for me some bottle? So if it's possible, I would like to have a little bit more. Anyway, thank you very much. Wine is beautiful, wine is great, and I'm very, very happy and pleased to hear you.
Okay. And with you, your cooperation,
thank you.
We think our company will be more and more at the top in all market around the world.
No, because you are very good.
This is it's very simple now to produce the format for the global testing. Like I said in the introduction, we create the format because we made the first global testing in the world in 2015 with the cooperation of British Telecom. Is five continent connected in that occasion. Thank you for the cooperation.
Thank you very much. Bye. See you.
I want to say thanks to everybody. Thanks to support us. Thanks to not only to join us today, but to keep our brands always at the first positions in your target. We are extremely happy and honored to be represented in your countries from all of you. Thank you very much to everybody. Thank you.
Okay, thank you also for me, from me. And this is the example of the technology, and is also the effect of the COVID. But this is a very positive effect of the COVID. Not all is bad. Sometimes we can have the courage to keep the innovation, and probably we must create a program for regular global testing, two or three per year. I think is the good occasion because we hope in the next month we'll can travel, but this is the occasion also for said this system is fantastic. Goodbye.